Okay guys, welcome to Scrap Garden, the full game. Hopefully this one continues off exactly where the last one left off. So let's jump right into it.
This amazing story happened to one old and small robot, serial number C4A, whom other robots called Just Kenny. The robot city had a strict policy about the renovation of outdated robots, and the cold nuclear fusion generator that was powering C4N had long been considered environmentally hostile. Kenny had to be put to sleep and woken up later with a new, polished, and shining body. He did fall asleep and saw a very strange dream. Everything around him came to a halt and started to get covered with rust and moss, and wanted to run away, but couldn't move. He wanted to scream, but he barely had enough energy to squeak. Eventually, he woke up. What happened to the city of robots? Why did all the robots stop moving? Did anyone survive except him? The little rusty Kenny had to do all he could to find answers to these questions and try to fix it all.
Okay. Where do we go? I need power. I can't move without solar energy. So avoid all shadows. Okay, so now I can move freely. Find another battery to open the door. Well, this container's full of them.
Thank you.
Okay. Well. You broke it. You broke it. Okay, Tanny. This time we're collecting rubies, not bolts, so I don't know what the fuck I need those for. I don't know what the games do, if they unlock a special part of the story or what. Let me know down in the comments below. One second, so being all laggy. No, it just gets laggy in this area. Let's see if I can get it to clear up a little bit. I'm not even sure where I'm supposed to go because I couldn't see anything over there. Thank you. Basketball's fucking huge. Right now, I guess I just collect the rubies. But everything's deteriorated so much. Ow. Well, this place is eerie as all hell. Not this way. Really, Kenny, at a time like this? I think this robot is extremely bored.
See a living robot again. But how is it that you are still working? Solar cells? Why, of course. You must be the only remaining robot with such remarkable archaic modules. Well, 54 years have passed since that dark day, but I remember it as if it were yesterday. Everyone was going about their business when the great black wings appeared in the sky. The black wings of a dragon. Yes. Yes, a real dragon. It was a vicious and relentless beast. It landed on the tower, clasped its claws around the crystal, and crushed it. The crystal's enormous energy was released in a brilliant flash, and all life in our city stopped. And I am the one to blame. Yes, it is all my fault. After all, I was the Watchman, and it was my duty to protect the crystal. But I failed. I myself can still move only because I am close to its ruins. Until now, I thought that I survived only as a punishment for my guilt. But now, I see that together we have a chance to make everything right. After the crystal had been destroyed, 4 or 5 beams from the power sources are indeed broken. But the last, to the north, miraculously remains undamaged. If you could manage to start the standby generator in the basement, perhaps I could activate the teleport to the northern lands. Take my stick, it is the key to the basement.
Okay. So now there's dragons and robots. And we're back to the eerie music. Key required. What the fuck? Robots can't go in water. I think I found a secret passage. Or I was supposed to come down here, one or the other. Ow, you fucking spider. Ow. Give me one of these. I don't know if I got a key or not, but I guess I did. Okay then. Fuck you. Simple.
0 and 1. Canning, you started the generator. No one knows what happened to the power stations in the provinces. Everything must have been completely eaten with rust there, But if we were able to repair those beams and focus them within the tower once again, we would have a chance to grow a new great crystal. You are a real robot, Cammy. If only I had been as brave that day. I will wait for your radio signal here, and good luck, my friend.
Although Cammy was a robot, he did not trust teleports too much. And though he seemed calm on the outside, deep inside he was afraid. However, dimensional transport of matter went off without a hitch. The northern province appeared to be a desolate but beautiful place. For a moment, Cammy even forgot why he had come here. When suddenly...
Wow. Everything here is trying to kill me. I don't like it.
Greetings, traveler. I see that you have an independent power supply, haven't you? After we had lost all means of communication with the city. I became a hermit and learned to extract energy from the world around us. Back then, I found a cave, and it revealed something to me. I found that everything around us, the earth, wind, and sun, is full of energy, but we just let it slip through our fingers like sand. Do you want me to teach you? I guess I can open up the cave for you. Once inside, you will discover its secrets for yourself. Yet, in order to conduct the ritual, I will require a handful of crystals and a new electrolyte boiler.
Well, the crystal part I can do. I don't know about electrolyte boiler. Ha, fuck off, spider. I'm assuming this is what you mean. Few more, how many? That's 60. That's a lot more than a few. Come here, Scorpion. Thank you. Well, fuck. Get get up there. I have no idea what that says or means, so... Wait, is there anything over here? Oh no, this is just a teleporter. Okay. I gotta find more things. An area that I have not been to. Now I'm done over here.
Looks like everything is ready to go. Amo kato de lorato soketo unprocrato.
So, okay.
Go forth and discover the secrets of the cave.
Whatever you say, weird robot dude. So what is that one? It's the F symbol. And you are not the F symbol. The R symbol. The whatever the fuck that is symbol. M symbol, and then the C symbol. No fucking clue what that did.
Incredible.
None at all.
It's a brand new power module for the mountain base. I haven't seen anything like it for ages. It seems that the cave gives its visitors what they need the most. Venture forth towards your destiny, traveler, and I will ask the wind and sun to guide your way.
Okay, weird man. No fucking clue. Knock you over. Matt, go where? Not touch the spikes. That's where I'm going. Not touch the spikes. Shiny thingy, what do you want? Aha! It needs a wheel thing. those two. What the fuck am I supposed to do here? Yeah, I have no fucking clue what I'm doing. Okay. A boss that doesn't even really attack you. Only when you're an idiot and stand in its path. I needed a giant red cog that now is small. Ow. Because I'm dumb. I pushed you over earlier, damn it. Is there another one over here? Yes, there is.
Hello? Can you hear me? Danny, is that you? May I be eaten by rust? It worked. The beam is reaching the tower just as before.
bad news is that I see no return signal from the teleport on your side. It seems that it's either broken or only functioning in one direction. I won't be able to teleport you back, Cammy. You need to find some other way to get into the Eastern Province. What are you saying? You met a giant worm? I've never heard of this biological species inhabiting the Northern Province, but I guess much has changed in the world over these years. Try to contact me from the Eastern base as soon as you get there. I will prepare the crystal to receive the second beam, and the rest is up to you. Be careful, Cammy.
Like other robots of his class, Cammy was never equipped with any complex computational units. Scientific research was not included in his instructions. However, he remembered the knowledge of physics and aerodynamics from the original firmware quite well. Besides, Cammy has always dreamed of flying and spent a long time watching the birds up in the sky. He was not sure whether his idea would work, but there was only one way to find out.
That's not how flying works, but okay.
Kenny's excitement was beyond any expression. The unbelievable feeling of free flight, breathtaking views of land spreading to the horizon, wind blowing in his face, all this gave him a feeling of freedom he never had before. It felt like there was nothing in the whole world that could stop him. Or at least, almost nothing.
I was hoping to find a wrench. That's why. Okay. On that note, I think it's a good stopping point for us. But we will continue back here with some more of Cammy's adventures in Scrap Garden in the next video. But until then, I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye-bye.